Welcome to Strength of Materials. This is video related to simple stress and strain. In this video, a numerical on elongation of bar. A bar of uniform section 20 mm diameter is subjected to loads as shown in figure. Find the total elongation of the bar and the maximum stress in the bar. E, Young's modulus is equals to 200 GPa, all length are in mm. So this is the question figure which is given, wherein the three sections are there with a separation of a line in between them. There are three sections. Each section is having a different length, where we can see the first section. So let us take this as A point and this as B point, this intermediate one more as C point, and the end one as D point. So A to B, we know that this is 400 mm, and B to C given is 1000 mm, C to D is given as 800 mm, and the diameter of all is of uniform section, which is 20 mm in dia, And we can see loading pattern is given different, such as 50 kilonewton pull is there on A side, B side 10 kilonewton pull is there, and C side 10 kilonewton pull is there from C to D, and D side the 60 kilonewton pull is there. So let us see about the solution part of this particular problem. Solution: the total elongation will be the sum of the elongation of individual section. So we need to take this into consideration. We have to divide each section into separate section. So let us take the section one by one. This, let us take this as section number one, A to B. This, let us take this as section number two, B to C. And the third one, this as section number three, C to D. With this, we'll take further part. AB, BC and CD, the free body diagram of each, we have to draw it. So free body diagram of each means separate section of each we have to draw. So this is for the section number one. So section number one, we can see at A point, the pull is of 50 kilonewton. The same amount of pull will be acting on the other side, which is 50 kilonewton. Now don't worry about this particular 10 kilonewton. Where there does this 10 kilonewton gone? So where it is, we'll be seeing with this as the second section, we will be able to find out that. So I'll draw the 10 kilonewton load, which is there as per the given in question. But where this is going to be come into account, let us see. So this is the 10 kilonewton as acting, and 50 kilonewton tension, same 50 kilonewton equal and opposite in tension. Clear? So going further for the next section. So coming to second section. So second section is of 1000 mm length, and load is now showing as 40 kilonewton. Why this load is showing as 40 kilonewton? I'll be just explaining you. So we can say that this is 50 kilonewton, this is 40 kilonewton. So what I have considered for B to C, to make it clear, here the part of 10 kilonewton is acting in this direction. So this is B point and this is C point. If I take this point, the 10 kilonewton is acting in this direction. To make it more clear, if I take that B point, the 10 kilonewton is acting in this direction. So considering this 10 kilonewton or this, all three are same. Now how I got this 50 and how I got 40 kilonewton? So 50 kilonewton, which is acting on the external side, this load, minus the internal opposite direction load, I will just minus it off. So I am able to find out how much load is acting. It is acting as 40 kilonewton. So 40 kilonewton is acting in which direction? So we are seeing this is in this direction, means moving from B. This is also moving from B in the opposite direction. So we can say this is in this direction. 10 is also in this direction. That is the difference. So to make this difference, 40 kilonewton is able to act in this direction. Means to get 10 kilonewton, we can say 40 minus 50, we are able to find out 10 kilonewton, which is acting in left to right direction. So this force is the 10 kilonewton, how it is going to act, and it is shown in the question. Now coming to the second section, 40 kilonewton is known to us. We will be taking 40 kilonewton on one side. Similarly, 40 kilonewton is also acting on the other side. Okay. Now this 40 kilonewton is acting, but where is this particular part of 20 kilonewton is coming or going? So to see this 20 kilonewton, going to the section 3 free body diagram. So section 3 free body diagram is like this. So we got it at this particular point. So 40 kilonewton is acting in this direction. So if we take 40 minus 60 minus 20, we are able to get. So that is acting in which direction? It is acting in this direction, which is as per the given question. So how much is the exactly force? It is as externally given as 60 kilonewton, which is acting on the other side also. So we need to consider what are the loads acting on the member. So on first member, P1 is acting as 50 kilonewtons. On second member, P2, load is acting as 40 kilonewtons. And on third member, P3 is acting as 60 kilonewtons. Clear? So this loading pattern we have to consider: 50 kilonewton on P1, 40 kilonewton on P2, and the P3 as considering 60 kilonewtons, not other than this. All other dimensions remain same and length as per the sections. So moving for the further calculation. Further calculation. So further calculation is this much. That is, the further calculation will be taking as, for each of the sections, the change in length is given by delta L PL by AE. Appropriate numerical values corresponding to the section being considered. So let us take for AB as delta L1. So here P1 is there, L1 is there, and A1 is there. So A1 is what? Area. So I'll just make out A1 is equals to A2, because the uniform section is there for us. So A1 is equals to A2 and it is equals to A3. So we can say that this all area remains the same as pi by 4 of diameter square, which is 20 mm diameter square. Clear? So whatever the value comes, that we will be substituting for all the three. Now considering P1 is known to us, which is 50 kilonewton, L1 is known to us, which is 400, then A1, E is common to all, it is Young's modulus, 200 GPa, that is 200 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. Substituting all the values in terms of Newton and mm, substituting all the values in terms of Newton and mm only, not other than these values. So now 50 kilonewton will be 50,000 multiplied by 400 is the length, divided by area calculated with this formula as A1 and E value. We are able to see that delta L1 is 0.318 mm. Coming to for BC delta L2, similarly same formula PL P2 L2 A2 E. Load is 40 kilonewtons, so 40,000 multiplied by 1000 is the length and area as A2, then E as 200 GPa, that is 200 into 10 raised to 3 I have written here. So value comes out to be 0.637 mm. For CD, how much is the load? Delta L3, P3 L3 divided by A3 E. 60,000 into 800 divided by 314.16, that is the area which is of pi by 4 into 20 square into the 200 GPa, that is the Young's modulus. So final value of delta L3 is 0.764 mm. Now finding this all total change in length, that is total change in length will be delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3. Substituting the values as found earlier, we get the total delta as 1.719 mm. So that is delta L is equals to 1.719 mm. So this part of the value is for the delta L1. Clear? Now coming to what is the value of maximum stress we need to determine. Maximum stress is how much? So for the cross section of the members, we are seeing that the load is 50 kilonewton, 40 kilonewton and 60 kilonewton. We need to consider the maximum stress. We will consider the section as CD. So in section CD, we can see that P loading, the load which is acting, which is of P3, is maximum because it is 60 kilonewtons. So taking the 60 kilonewton into account, we calculate the maximum stress, 60,000 divided by the area, which is sigma is equals to P by A is the formula. By this we find out 191 newton per mm square as the stress. So sigma is the maximum stress. Please do write here sigma max and write the final value as 191 newton per mm square. This is the value of the final of this numerical. Moving to second numerical, or the second numerical of this video and total ninth numerical of the elongation of bar. Still more are there, but this I am taking before the derivation is being solved, because I thought with the previous problem you are able to understand this, though I will be providing you the derivation of this also for the non-equal sections of the bars. So a bar has a three sections of different diameters, 120 mm, 80 mm and 100 mm, and is load of 500 kilonewton. So the loading is 500 kilonewton common it is. There is no change in loading. Now there is change in diameter. So we can see the diameter here and diameter here, all three are separate. So the total elongation is to be determined and maximum stress is to be determined. It is similar to previous problem, and Young's modulus E is directly given, that is 200,000 MPa. MPa means newton per mm square. Don't get confused. It is megapascal means newton per mm square. It is 10 raised to 6 newton per meter square. So if you divide it by meter square to mm square, we are dividing it by 10 raised to 6. So make it so clear. MPa, okay, which is 10 raised to 6 newtons per meter square. I require this value into mm square. So what I'll do, I'll be writing like this: 10 raised to 6 newton divided by meter square it is. Clear? I'll divide this meter to get in mm. So I'll divide this meter square by 10 raised to 6 divide. So what will happen? division means denominator of denominator will become as numerator. Now what will be the value? It will be similar to like this, 10 raised to 6 into this 10 raised to 6 will be coming with minus 10 raised to 6. It is minus 10 raised to 6. Now the value is what? Newton per mm square, because we are converted that this meter square to mm square. This is now mm square. So this value is what? This value is same as MPa. So don't get confused with MPa, that what is the value. It is directly given in terms of Newton per mm square. Only we need to understand this part of calculation. This part of calculation is most important to convert the units. So let us see the problem. So problem, let us take this as section 1. Section 2 and this as section 3. Okay, then I will be taking this as AB. If you require, you can change the names. This as BC, this as CD. Clear? Then length of AB is how much? 400 mm. Length of BC is how much? 800 mm. Length of CD is how much? 600 mm. What is given? Diameter of AB is how much? 120 mm. Diameter of BC is how much? 80 mm. Diameter of CD is how much? 100 mm. So let us proceed with the loading given common as 500 kilonewtons. 500 kilonewtons, the load common. Let us go for further part. So what we will do? Free body diagram. The total elongation will be sum of the elongations of the individual sections AB, BC and CD. So as marked earlier, AB, BC and CD. Clear? So this is section 1, section 2 and section 3. 500 kilonewton, how it is acting? So let us see for first section. So this is the 500 kilonewton, equal and opposite it is acting. We can see this. So this part of tension is acting. Now this 500 kilonewton, which is acting on the right side, which is at the B point, will make equal and opposite sense on BC member. So that how it will be acting? It will be acting in this way. So we can see at B point, there is equal and opposite section force acting. Similarly, at C point on section 3, again there is a equal and opposite amount of 500 kilonewton force is going to act. Clear? So this was the free body diagram. Now to find out the change in length, we have the formula as delta L is equals to PL by AE. Delta L is equals to PL by AE. Now what we will do for section 1, delta L1, P1, L1, A1. Why A1? Area is separate. Now we need to calculate separate area for all. Okay, section 1, section 2, section 3. And length of all the sections are also separate. P is only common in all the section. Clear? Okay. So section number 1, the force is acting 500 kilonewton for 1B. Delta L1, P1, L1 divided by A1, E1. So substituting the values, 500 kilonewton into L1 is 400 mm. Area of this particular diameter, pi by 4 into 120 square. And E value, 2 lakh MPa, Newton per mm square. So we got this value as 0.088 mm. Similarly, for BC, delta L2, substituting all the values in the same formula with the values of second section and calculating, we are able to get the delta L2 as 0.397. Then coming for CD problem, delta L3, P3, L3 divided by A3, E3. So this value, we can see this as 500 kilonewton multiplied by length is 600 and area as 100 mm square. Then E is Young's modulus, 2 lakh MPa Newton per mm square, and we get the value as delta L3 0.190 mm. Clear? So now total we have to do. So this plus this plus this will give us the value as delta L, total elongation. Now, which will be the maximum force which is acting or maximum stress, we will see. So, this, the total elongation will be the sum of elongations of the individual section AB, BC and CD, delta 1 and delta L2, delta L3. Substituting the values, we get the total elongation as 0.675 mm, delta L as 0.675 mm. If we require stress we have to calculate separately, such as sigma 1, separate sigma 2, separate and sigma 3, separate, because area is changing. So, what is that particular part of formula? I'll tell you. It is P 1 divided by A 1, and for sigma 2, P 2 divided by A 2, and sigma 3 will be able to see that P 3 divided by A 3. So, this, out of this, whichever will be the maximum stress, that will be the maximum stress for the problem. Clear? So, now one more question I am giving you as an assignment. Determine the stress in each section of a bar in the following figure when subjected to an axial tensile load of 20 kN. So, load is acting as 20 kN common. The central section, so the B section, is of square section. The other portions are of circular. So, I am making highlighting square section and circular section. So, please remember, square area is separate and circular area is separate. Square area for area. So, I will just calculate A of B, means B section, which is as 30 multiplied by 30 is the area. 30 multiplied by 30 is the area, as it is in the square section. And for other, AA is the circular part, which is pi by 4 into d square. What is d square now? The diameter is given as 20 mm square. So, we can have this. Then AC, the area of C section, which is having again circular section. So, pi by 4 and multiplied by diameter as 15 square. Clear? Try this problem and try to submit the assignments also. Thank you. Thank you. See you in the next video.